Aviation is a very male-dominated field, especially pilots that work as commercial pilots. But that doesn't mean that it's not a great career field for women. There's a lot of different opportunities. I would like to see more women in aviation.
I'm Rachel Obermoller, and I'm a pilot.
I work for the Minnesota Department of Transportation in the Office of Aeronautics as an aviation representative, and what we do is inspect airports around the state. We work with airports on operational issues. We teach safety seminars for pilots. We are sort of the operational experts in terms of airports.
This is our state's King Air 200, and before we go flying tonight, I need to do a pre-flight inspection, so I'm going to walk around the airplane and check the lights and the oil and where the fuel level is, and just make sure that everything's in good condition and ready for passengers.
Right now, the work and home life balance is really great. I get to be home most nights with my son, but I also get to fly and not just be sitting at a desk all day long. I've been flying for more than half my life. I started flying when I was 16. Today, I'm gonna go fly with my coworker, Kelly.
So what do you think? We'll be heading down to South St. Paul?
Yeah, I think, do you want to shoot that approach first?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, what do they have in Arnett?
When we go out to fly, we plan a lot of things ahead of time. We're looking at the weather, we're looking at where we're going to go, we're having to look into what the conditions are at the airport and call and get a weather briefing. It's being able to think ahead of what's going to happen.
Clear!
So as soon as we're airborne, if you want to call tower and just say we're inbound St. Paul, and
yep,
then hopefully they'll clear us into the airspace.
To be a good pilot, you need to know your multiplication tables. And I know that sounds kind of funny, but in aviation, we use a lot of science and math, particularly science related to aerodynamics and how an airplane flies or how a system works on an airplane, meteorology, understanding the weather.
It looks good. Yep, we look clear.
And then part of the other work that I do, we work with airports on airport inspections, and we're talking about three-dimensional surfaces in space and visualizing different shapes and geometry. With both of them, we use a lot of math, a lot of like quick algebra in our heads, or maybe just simple trigonometry or geometry.
St. Paul Tower, but at the 1-4 Mike November is off at South St. Paul. I'd like to be inbound to land.
Bonanza 14 Mike November, St. Paul Tower, make straight in for runway 32, number 2.
Flying now does feel a little bit like just getting into a car, but I think that's good because it means that it's comfortable and it's second nature. There's still situations that happen where you kind of get a little adrenaline rush or it's something out of the ordinary and it's a challenging situation, but the same thing happens in a car when somebody pulls out in front of you in traffic or you slide on the ice. So I think it's good that it's comfortable, but there's times where your heart really beats fast too. There's a lot of women in aviation who have broken down barriers for those of us that work in the field right now. From the first women who did any sort of flying for the military, the WASPs during World War II, to the first female airline pilots. I'm really grateful for those women for having had the courage to really stand for that and to fight for their rights to be able to make that decision. We live in a beautiful state. We have beautiful lakes and rivers and forests, and it's always beautiful to see a sunrise or a sunset when we're flying. Aviation is a great career field for women. It's really interesting and challenging.